Some rockets use solid fuels to generate thrust that propels the rocket in a forward motion. Thrust occurs when chemical reactions in the rocket engine produce gases which move the rockets. In this session, we'll simulate the use of solid rocket fuel and learn about how changes to the surface area and temperature affect the chemical reaction rates that produce gases for thrust. We'll need the materials shown in this video for the experiment. First, fill the jar with room temperature water, then put one whole antacid tablet and time the reaction until the tablet is entirely dissolved. Repeat this step two more times and record the results you get each time. Next, repeat the same experiment, but this time round, use one crushed tablet. Time the reaction until you no longer hear fizzy sounds. Repeat this test again two more times, just like the previous one, and record the results. We'll then repeat the very same experiment, but with hot water instead of room temperature water. Do it three times, just like the previous one, and record the results. In this experiment, we've seen that crushed tablets dissolve faster than whole ones, which means that when we increase the surface area of the tablet, it decreases the time it takes for the tablet to dissolve. We've also seen that hot water increases the rate of reaction. This is because hot water has molecules that vibrate and move faster than those in cold water. Antacid tablets and solid rock fuel are similar in that they both contain stored energy. We used water to activate the chemical reaction in the antacid tablets, and similarly, fire is used to activate the chemical reaction in solid rocket fuel. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe for more fun science experiments and activities. Thank you.